So what does it cost to develop a mobile application? I've been asked this question hundreds of times, and developing a mobile application that's quality and really impacts your business is so paramount in a mobile generation that we're living in. Mobile applications can cost anywhere from thousands of dollars to millions of dollars, and I'm going to get into the formulas of how leading mobile app developers across the world are using to calculate the cost of a mobile application and what you can do to impact that cost in a positive way if you're an entrepreneur thinking about developing a mobile application for your product or company. When thinking about a mobile application, I usually tear it down into four different sections. There's the front end, or the front end visual portion of the application. This is typically what's on the mobile application itself. There's the back end of the application. This is what happens on the server. This can be storing of information or retrieving of information. And then there's the design portion of the application, how that application looks, feels, the user experience, the design of that product. And lastly, the testing and the quality. And how much you spend on quality and design, those are two elements that don't often get talked about, but those elements can really significantly impact both the quality of the application and how much money you're spending. So let's take a simple example of an application that really has just three screens. It may have a login screen, so you have to enter a username and password and hit submit. It may have a profile screen that may have the profile of the person who's logging in, and it may have an upload photo screen. So very simple application, doesn't do a lot. Now you'd break that application down into its components. So what would it take an engineer to code the front end portion of a login screen? And that may be something that could be done in a couple days, to what would it take to develop the profile section of the application? Again, retrieving information from the server. Again, maybe there's a name and profile picture, a little bit of information you want to retrieve from the server. And then lastly, taking a photo and uploading it. In even that simple type of application, there's going to be a lot of gotchas or things to think about. Do you have to log in with Apple ID? Is there going to be a different login flow on Android than on iPhone? So all these little gotchas go into the estimation, and more experienced engineering firms will think through some of those scenarios even prior to starting an application. More junior firms may or may not take those into consideration. So really make sure you understand the requirements and what your application has to do before diving in and asking for estimates. Now, because talent is very diverse, and global talent especially is very diverse, you'll see a range of prices for development firms from $200, $300 an hour on onshore development work to $20 to $50 an hour for offshore development work. And you'll see everything in between. And this is really based on the quality of the engineers, the seniority of the engineering talent, and seniority of the design talent that's working on a particular product. Now, more expensive by the hour does not necessarily mean that the end application will be more expensive, because sometimes those more senior engineers can save you money down the road by making the right decisions in the first place. So really evaluate both your budget and the seniority and talent that's going to be working on an application to make sure you're really getting what you expect. The other consideration you should really think about is the architecture that you're choosing for your application. Some developers will use technologies like React Native or Flutter to build an application in a cross-platform way. That can save you costs from not having to develop an Android version separately from an iPhone version, but these technologies have trade-offs. So just make sure you're aware of the trade-offs before you sign up for a particular architecture. The leading application developers will tend to develop their applications using native technology, native to Apple and native to Android, and these technologies provide a great experience, but they can also be significantly more expensive. So just make sure you understand the architectural choices and the pros and cons of the approach that you're taking. So what are some of the typical costs and timelines for building a mobile application? Well, it really depends on the features and complexity of the product, but it's really typical for apps to be developed in somewhere between 4 to 6 months of time. I find that taking longer to develop an application is somewhat problematic in that you're waiting a long time to see what the customer's reaction to that product might be. And taking less than 4 months can really be too fast in terms of not taking enough time to build a quality application, to test it effectively, and make sure it has enough features to be really impactful in the marketplace. In terms of the size of team, it really, again, depends on the number of features, but having a person per platform, meaning at least an engineer on iPhone, an engineer on Android, and a designer working on the product throughout the length of the project is really what I recommend as the minimum to make sure you're having enough time to build the right quality. So far, we've really talked about the upfront cost of building the initial application, but the real thing you should consider is the long-term ongoing cost of building an application. Most applications that are successful end up being maintained by an engineering team over the course of an entire year. And so if you're thinking about building an application and it's going to be core and central to your business, you should really think about operationalizing that team across the entire year as well. Lots of mobile teams from smaller startups end up being teams of 2 or 3 people, and then larger companies can deploy teams of 50 or even 100 people to make sure their mobile application is performing well. This can be huge amounts of money and huge percentages of your engineering team, and if your product is moving the needle for your business and your business is truly mobile first, this will be a true investment into the future of your company. While the cost of these applications can be significant, the impact that these applications can have on your business can be profound. We're seeing businesses drive 60, 70, 80% of their core business from their mobile applications. And if your business is mobile first, you might be able to do the same. Thanks so much for joining me. I'm Greg Raiz. Until the next one.